What you need to know in advertising today. The Simpsons YouTube, a host of big media companies, have come to a difficult realization: the enemy of the digital duopoly may be my new best friend. The duopoly, of course, is Facebook and Google, and, to battle its growing dominance in digital advertising, media players ranging from CBS to ESPN to Hearst and News Corporation are pooling together their ad space. The vision is to create a centralized digital outlet where ad buyers can find the best, safest places to run their ads outside of the Google and Facebook domain. To read more about how media companies are banding together to fight Google and Facebook, click here. In other news, Hewlett-Packard Enterprise took a Quartz ad and turned it into a news bot. Hugo, developed by Quartz Creative and Digitasleby, was first trialed on Quartz's website and is now a chatbot on Facebook Messenger that delivers innovation news and also touts the company. Senator Al Franken is doubtful Facebook, Google, and Twitter can police their sites and is calling for vigorous oversight by regulators. In a speech, Senator Al Franken cast doubts on the big tech companies' ability to police their sites. Under fire for pointing kids to disturbing videos, YouTube promises to put in place new age restrictions. YouTube said it plans to start putting age restrictions on videos involving children's characters that have been flagged for having inappropriate content. Twitter stops its verification program after giving its verified badge to the organizer of the Charlottesville Unite the Right rally. The company says the suspension is only temporary and that it is working on a fix. Apple's video app got a new update with augmented reality and a bunch of Star Wars stuff. The Clips app now makes use of the iPhone Extra Depth Camera. TripAdvisor will now warn users about hotels where sexual assault has been reported. It had previously come under fire after some users reported their accounts of rape and assault were removed from the site. AT&T CEO Randall Stephenson said he would do whatever it takes to get a deal done with Time Warner, The Wall Street Journal reports. He reiterated that he has no intentions to sell CNN. Cheddar is launching Cheddar Big News, its second channel, DigiDe reports. The new channel will be modeled after CNN's headline news, in that it will focus on the biggest news stories of the day, but done in the style and sentiment of local news. Lip-syncing video app Musical.ly is selling for at least $800 million, £609 million, Recode reports. It's being acquired a Chinese media startup. Join us at Ignition, Future of Media. Future of Media is November 29 to 30 in New York City. We hope to see you there. Follow us at @bycorporate to be among the first to hear about news and updates from Business Insider. Also, sign up for the Executive Summary, a new bi-weekly newsletter that brings the latest marketing news, trends, and company updates